We play and call it work.
Hey there, and welcome to a special show today. We're actually going to be playing a game of the Assassinorum Execution Force. And we've already done one game through of this one, just to see how it runs. Just because we want to make sure we're getting everything on the camera and not having to fumble through rules quite a bit. So with us today, well, first off, there's me. We have Steve with us.
Hey.
We have Quirk with us. And our special guest today is Josh. So basically, we've all already chosen an assassin to play through this mission on with, and we're basically going to film it as we go along, and it's going to be one long video. Basically, we're going to try and keep it as unedited as possible, simply because part of the fun of a cooperative game is the banter that happens between us. So anyway, we're going to go take a look at the board and get started. All right, so there it is, the Assassinorum Execution Force. Now, unfortunately, we were not able to get the boxed assassins ready for this one. So we are just going to be using the studio assassins right here. So from left to right, you can see the Calidus assassin, the Evisor assassin, Vindicare assassin, and Kaluxus assassin. Behind there, there's all the renegade forces right there. So there's a whole bunch of cultists, some marines. And right over here, we have Lord Drask, who is going to be the chaos sorcerer that we are going in to kill. So there is the board itself. So we have the Sanctum right, or the Astropath, the Astropathic something or other. The first part of the board right there, where we'll get the name for you. And then we have the Sanctum right there, and that's where we have to kill the sorcerer. So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna set up a steady cam watching the game as we all play, and hopefully you guys enjoy.
It's working.
So the whole idea here is, as we move through the board here, we're going to be revealing rooms. Each one of these little grayed out boxes is going to be a room. And the whole idea is we're trying to find the teleporter control room and the teleporter itself. Now once we find that teleporter and we activate it with the control room, we warp into here, starting right there. And then it's a whole new ball game in which we have to start fighting consistent Space Marines as well as a Space Marine Terminator Lord as well, the Sorcerer. So hopefully our teamwork is going to be able to get us through on this one, and it doesn't just result in us doing what we did last time, which Quirk was running through the field, banging his rifle on everything, attracting everyone. But who knows, it might happen again. Anyway, moving on to the game. So this here is the Inner Sanctum. So the whole idea is once we get to this area, we're going to try and kill the Terminator, or the Chaos Sorcerer Lord. Now, you'll see the little familiar, this fella right there. The whole idea is that every turn that progresses, so that's both Assassin and Chaos turn, he's going to progress one more on the numbered chart right there. If he ever hits 16, we lose. So that means that becomes a Chaos victory, the Assassins lose, we can't do anything about it. Now he can ignore anyone standing on one of those tiles that he goes onto, whereas instead if he just occupies it as well, he actually skips forward one additional tile. So we have to be careful about getting in the way as well. So yeah, as you can see how Quirk is, yeah, just like that. So basically, he can never occupy the same tile. Instead, he just jumps over and skips another one. So we can actually hurt ourselves by doing that. All right, so we're doing the setup part of the game here. So at the very start, we roll 4d6, and that determines where cultists with auto guns are going to be showing up. So the first cultist shows up on a 2. The second cultist, 5, next one, 3, and the last one is a 4. So all the cultists are set up. You can see that we have the 4 assassins set up right here, and we are good to go. So at this point, because it's a cooperative game, we all get to discuss how we're going to go about doing this. So, so we have Steve and Dave at the very front of the pack here.
Well, we got one room that's very easy to unlock, and one is kind of hidden around a couple of walls, but we gotta get to it early. So I'm gonna go run for that one right away.
Okay.
So if someone can move me 6 spaces towards the far wall.
This one right over here?
Yeah, close to that one if we can.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And then I'm going to sprint.
Here's some dice for you guys over there.
Sure. Sprinting d6. 2. Send me 2 more.
1, 2.
And look me down the hall. There we go.
Perfect. Okay, right down the hall there.
So, and check out that room.
So again, just gotta go to here through my movement. So
okay.
That puts me at 4. Let's see what's in there.
So what is that? So because there's a three on the blackout room there, basically how it works is we draw three room cards, and then we look at the cards themselves, and the one with the lowest number is the one that we place on the tile itself. And then we'll see chaos symbols, and that determines how many cultists show up.
10, 7, and 2. So the 2 is the one that gets picked, so these two go back in.
Yep, and they just go to the bottom of the deck there.
This goes right here.
Okay, and we put one. I think that's actually where it showed up in our practice.
That's exactly
that. Yeah. That's the exact same template, yeah.
Yep. So that would have been 2, 4 for me, so I still have 2 more tiles for movement.
And because this chaos renegade showed up, he has been stunned until the start of our next turn.
Yep. So since I'm better at shooting, I'm going to move 1, 2, and look this way.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to attempt to shoot. So because I'm using a Exodus weapon, it's +1 for hitting. And that'll do it.
Alright. So you just blew the cultists away.
Yep.
Do you want to go next, Josh?
Yeah, sure. I'm going to head over towards Steve, give him a hand like that, in case things go wrong.
Whoa. What's this teamwork stuff about? What's going on here?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then sprint. 1.
Not very fast there.
Alright, you're all a bunch of cowards. So I'm just going to run forward here. So 2, 4, 6. I'm going to, now the Evisor has his special ability. Where it allows him to use the same action twice in a single turn. So I'm just going to go another sprint forward. 2, 4, 5. Look that way. And 6. Looking that. Actually, I'm going to look back towards where the door is. And that is the end of the Assassin's turn 1. So the familiar moves up one space. So moving on to the rest of the Chaos turn. So at the start of, or at the second part of the Chaos turn, we have to draw an event card. We draw a minimum of 1, plus another 1 for every cultist that is on alert, up to 3 additional events. So our first event is going to be in a patrol. So basically we have to place a cultist with an autogun on entry point number 2, and facing the direction on the entry point itself. Now the event that entry point 2 is full, we place it on the next available entry point. So in this case...
2 is full, just right over there.
Yep, so in this case, we're placing a cultist on entry point number 1.
Alright, so sorry, I cut off that square, because I did not think it was going to come into play.
So I'll zoom over just a little bit so you didn't see it. Right there in the bottom left of your screen.
This fella right here. So now we move on to the randomized movement of the cultists themselves. So each one is going to operate on patrol at the moment. So the whole idea is we're going to discuss how we want to have these guys activate. We're going to roll a d6 for how far they move, and then we're going to determine if they have any line of sight on any of the assassins that show up. So who do we want to move first?
Do the farthest one.
Farthest one first.
He's moving forward 3. He lands on a directional tile. Why don't you roll for direction for me? 4, so he's going to be looking that way.
All right, they're already coming for us.
Why don't we do this guy next, just in case he happens to look there?
And he doesn't.
So we're good.
Excellent. So, and you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of arrows with numbers on the board. Whenever one of the cultists get to one of those arrows, we basically roll a d6, and that determines which way the cultist is then going to be facing. So let's get these out of the way. Let's move that other guy.
He's moving 1 directional tile. He's looking this way.
All right. And this fellow over here, gonna move 4. All right, and then this guy back here is gonna move 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, actually, I think he would've... before he actually turns, he's actually gonna see Steve's Calidus Assassin.
Yeah.
So at this point, he gets his reactionary, or... So he's now on alert. So what that means is if Steve moves into a square that's within line of sight of the cultist gets to make his attacks. It also means that on subsequent turns, the cultist is going to be heading towards the assassins for as long as he's alive. But for right now, that does end the cultist's turn.
So right now, dealing with that one guy who's alerted, I have a couple options here. My guy has a special ability to walk through those guys, through the chaos guys.
Yep.
So I can walk past him, turn around, stab him in the back. He will take a free shot at me.
Yeah.
And then Josh can come and see if he can get all the way through. But I can probably sprint into the sight of that room. and Josh can decide if he needs to come and help me over there or not. Make sense?
The thing is, if he takes a shot, because you only have two wounds.
Yeah.
So if he takes a shot and actually manages to land a hit, then you're walking into that room that could spawn three guys.
He doesn't have to move all the way up.
Yeah.
Don't worry about him.
I won't.
And if it spawns three guys, they're not going to kill him right
now. I have a free sprint, so I can heal myself if I need
to. This is true.
Yeah. Well, remember, one move is going to be to get behind
him. Second move is going to be my attack.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, so you're not going to get your heal until the default.
Well, if he hits me, I don't sprint, that's all. I don't think you will.
So is that what you want to do?
I think so. Move me 6, but stopping behind him.
So basically, as soon as you get him there, he's going to have line of sight on you. And this is one of the cultists with the auto guns. So they're going to get 2 shots, needing a 6.
No,
it's... Nope. All right. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're going to turn around like that, right?
And I will use my phase sword, which is +2 to hit. That'll kill him.
Yeah, I'll do it.
You just removed him.
And now you get your free sprint.
I get my free sprint because of who I am. 6 inches. I'll stalk 2 in front of the doorway.
So, right there?
Yeah, and they reveal that here.
Well, they're going to be stunned until their next turn anyway, right?
We have 11. That's definitely not going to be it.
Well, so we got number 1,
we have 8.
2 guys.
So 8 has to go on there first, yeah. So 8 goes on there first, and you have 2 autogun cultists looking at you now.
Let's use the rest of my movement to move me in base contact with the one the closest to you.
How much did you roll for your sprint?
I rolled 6, so I used 2.
So he's got 4
more.
Yeah,
just like that.
Just like that. Alright, so next up. Why don't, you can pop out there and shoot that cultist right there.
I could.
You could.
Or just to avoid, because as soon as he sees me, he's going to get alerted. If I miss,
you're just going to wake up the entire place again, aren't you?
I don't want to do that again. You guys yelled at me, and I won the game.
We're going to yell at you no matter what.
I can go like this, and then just hang out. He'll walk past me.
Well, you can go like that, and you can still shoot him.
Yeah.
Like, oh yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so you go right there.
You're... And he can't see you.
He can't. I can't see you, but... Or you can't see me, but I can see you. So yeah, looking for a 5, I guess.
Because you got +1 to it, right?
Yeah. I don't know, looking for a 3.
What is the resilience on a cultist?
4.
It's 4, right? Yeah, I need a 3. See, that's what I didn't want to have happen.
Oh.
You can use your tactics to reroll.
But that is true.
It's a cultist.
You want to, exactly, you want to waste it, not really.
Yeah, otherwise he goes on alert.
There we go.
Okay, so at least you killed him this time.
And there goes one of my special bullets.
Yeah. Okay. So,
Do you want me to try to get in the room and take care of that one?
I'm okay.
So do you want me to keep moving forward into the other room and see what happens?
Yeah, one has to punch and the other one can't see.
Well, no, they're both still stunned right now.
Yeah, they're going to be stunned until our next turn.
So you have your turn to activate where you can
hit
one.
I will kill one and then sprint over. Other. Yeah.
So.
Okay, so I'm okay. Let me move. Okay.
You can probably reveal the next
probably get in here.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Where do you go? 1, 2, 3.
Reveal a room.
So, 2 cards. So we have 6 and 5.
Ooh, is that a teleporter?
That is That's a teleporter.
So...
When you go to the teleporter, you're gonna find the activation room.
Okay. So that's where things get fun now.
And we got a cultist in there.
And one cultist guarding the teleporter.
I believe in you.
Yeah. So we'll go. So I move 3.
Yeah.
Go 4, 5.
One more you can get in range.
6. And let's take a shot at him. It's 2 dice on mine. Looking for a 4.
Wow, they were
and a blam. Alright. And now for me, I don't like being sneaky.
So,
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, you can use stop for
stop,
a turn.
Stop and look.
I don't want to look though.
Take a peek.
I don't want to look. I want to go kill him. Because I have to end my movement looking at it.
You don't?
No. Yeah. I don't want to look.
Alright, yeah,
yeah, yeah. You gotta reveal it when you go past, anyways.
But it's not line
of
sight.
No, if he keeps looking this way, he doesn't have to.
Yeah, it's not line of sight. Because I need to end line of sight there. So I'd rather just get up there and kill another one of these guys. So I got my 3 attacks on this. Need a single 4.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, there we go, we got him.
He did. Second act? Oh, those are both your
actions,
right?
Yeah, that was both my actions. And that ends the assassin's turn 2.
And moving on to turn, or marker number three.
So at the start of the cultist turn, we only have, well, we actually have no cultists that are on alert, so we're only drawing one event card again. In this case, random sweep. So a chaos cultist with an auto gun on the entry point, well, let's roll to see which entry point. Entry point one. Alright. Steve's gonna have some more companies pretty soon here.
I got this, guys.
You got this? You got this, Steve?
I got it.
Alright. Alright, so we gotta do some movement here for the cultists.
I'm gonna move this one way over here.
Gonna move him first?
He's going six.
He can see me!
Well, he stops right here. We have some 20 turns, actually. That's
no, because he's gonna walk as soon as he gets here. Sees me.
He's okay. Got that, and he sees there. Yeah.
So he has become on alert.
Now, does he have to make a shot at you, or does he have to continue his...
No, because he only actually has the one action.
Which is...
So, in this particular case, his action was the move.
Then he has to continue moving his full distance. He had a couple actions.
Now he starts moving towards, yeah. Right? But yeah, he can't...
So, four to there, then one.
Yeah, but he can't make any additional actions at this point, so...
What about that guy?
That guy!
He's going five. One, two, three, four, five.
All right.
And this one on the bottom corner.
Oh, yeah, the guy in the bottom corner there. One. He doesn't know what's going on. He's happy in his ignorance right now. Alright. So that is the end of the cultist movements, because these guys are still stunned until the beginning of the assassin turn.
Alright. So those guys go active now, right?
Yeah, so they're no longer stunned. They're now on alert. So if we don't deal with them, we're going to be drawing some extra event cards.
Alright, well, I'm definitely going to go ahead and attack the one directly in front of me. With my phase sword.
Yep.
I think I hit, because I'm plus two.
You're plus two?
I'm plus two to
swords. Then you got him.
Now, is that going to activate anything else around that I killed him with a melee attack?
Well, here's the problem. Nobody was in line of sight, right?
Yep.
So you don't have to worry about that. However, as soon as you start sprinting, if you go into these two squares right here, you're going to get shot at by him.
Okay. Well, I get a free sprint and another action, so I'm gonna go for the sprint.
And remember, you can't make another close combat action.
Oh.
You have to sprint and maybe shoot him, and then shooting will definitely alert him.
True. Okay, well, I will...
Why not try sprinting and getting out of the room? Because regardless, you're either gonna move here, and he's gonna hear you, and see you, and shoot at you.
They're both gonna shoot at
you. And they're both gonna become alerted. You can't kill either of them.
Let's see what happens when they're both gonna sprint. Let's see what we get. It's only low. Okay, three. How far can I get?
You can get...
I'm not gonna go high to anybody.
Where do you want to go? Like, you can go right there?
If I back up one square, I take a shot at the guy.
Nope.
Or not?
Because you don't have line of sight on
him. Line of sight's on an angle.
Line of sight operates this way, so you can see these three squares and forward.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
All right, so just bring me forward one square.
All right, and he's going to take a pot shot at you.
Yep. Misses.
He's not going to hit you, at least.
And,
Now, you can turn facing and do a shot, could you?
I'm gonna shoot the one that's already active.
Okay.
Which makes him colored and note.
My neural shredder has two shots.
Okay.
And no modifier, so hitting on a four. That'll kill him.
So you're definitely gonna kill him, but you're also gonna alert that cultist right there.
Correct.
Yeah.
Now, would that cultist there take a shot at him because he's at the 3 point there?
Yeah, actually. That cultist would have got the shot as well. And that one's gonna hit.
That'll hit, okay.
That one's gonna hit. So you're down to one wound.
Taking a wound.
Oh, we'll put it right next to your...
Perfect.
Your guy there. So, you've stirred the hornet's nest.
Josh, can you... No, how far do you have to go to just to even be able to shoot at him? You can't do it.
I gotta be within six, and I'm not gonna get around the corner.
Alright, I'll leave you alone then.
Yeah.
I'll be okay.
Alright, so how about we see what Quirk does with...
Okay. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See here. And I'm going to sprint and let's see how far I can get. 4. So I'm going to go 1.
Stop and see what's in there.
Let's see what's in there.
Alright, so what is that? That's 2 cards?
2 cards.
So we have 4 and 6.
I'm content
with 4. Or is that
4?
9?
That's 9.
No, that's 9, yeah.
That's it. Yeah,
4 is the one we take, though, because we take the lowest number.
I'm okay with this.
That's good. You didn't wake up the barracks full of guys this time.
No, I didn't. So that's good.
You would be in line to slay the guy, but he's going to be stunned. Right?
Yeah, but he's stunned at the moment, yeah.
And I still have 3 more inches.
You were on the enemy's line of sight.
I could. So it'd be 1, 2, 3. Or I could go 1, 2, 3 and start making my way into here.
Yeah.
Gonna open up
the worst that could happen.
Yeah, you know,
we're gonna see three more.
Why not? One, two, three. It's not like more guys are coming.
Exactly. You don't have line of sight just yet. So, all right, what are you gonna do, Josh?
Oh, let's see what happens. I think I'm gonna go probably wake up the other room. Or do you want to come towards you, Quirk, in case I can give you a hand on that side?
Well, the worst thing that's gonna happen is someone's gonna pop in here, and they're not gonna do anything. Because he's not going to do anything until next activation.
And you're going to shoot him first.
I'm going to shoot him.
So yeah. I guess, do you want me to stay close to you guys to support you, or do you want me to try to just keep exposing rooms?
I would suggest going and helping Steve, because I got Leland here.
Well, the thing is if I need help, I'm dead, which means don't worry about it.
Yeah.
So don't worry about me.
You're only dealing with one cultist at the
moment. Yeah, if he rolls another six, I'm dead, and that's it.
Yeah. There's nothing to be done about. Okay, so room or support, you guys.
Go for the room.
Okay.
I'm close enough to Quirk then.
One, if two, three, support. Four, five.
And that's another two rumor.
Another two.
So we have
a one.
It's definitely a one.
And we have a three. Yeah, it's definitely the one. And
there's one guy looking at the wall.
These cultists sure love their walls. Alright.
So what was that for total movement?
One, two, three, I think you're a four.
Four. So you can definitely move up and
go ahead. Yeah, let's move into melee with them. And try to stab him. Looking for 3+.
Is your life dream?
Nope.
Uh-oh.
Whole lot of nope.
So he's just on alert now. Okay. Apparently we're not very good assassins. Alright. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to just wreck this one cultist that I'm in combat with.
Or are you?
Or am I?
What's happening in this game?
Do you have any pluses? No,
nope,
you don't.
No, I have no pluses. So,
you can do a second action with the combat.
You can do a second attack.
I'm gonna have to do a second attack, yeah. Because I was supposed to wreck him.
No.
Barely.
Worst assassins ever. Wait, why am I taking my guy? I live. That's right. I'm not supposed to take my guy. So, I use both my actions to heal one cultist. I'm a big man now. Alright, and the little familiar moves on to four. So, we have. So at the start of the chaos phase, after the familiar's been moved, we have two cultists that are on alert. So we are now going to be drawing three event cards. So the first one is a patrol, chaos cultist on entry point 6, which is...
Whoa!
Oh, it's right there at the stairs.
Okay.
Yeah. So he's going to pop up right there. Then, prescient flicker. Choose a renegade that is on patrol. That renegade immediately goes on alert.
I choose this one.
Yeah.
You know what? I agree.
Yeah, anyone else is dangerous. So he's on alert, but he's going the wrong way. Right,
so he's on alert. And the last one.
Stun? Is it a stun?
No, it's a patrol at entry number 4. Oh, good.
He's on alert.
Yeah, he's on alert. So I'm going to get a face full of las gun or auto pistol here. That's going to be fun. So how do you guys want to activate these guys?
Well, give me an alert marker for this guy so you just remember.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, let's see what this guy does.
Yeah.
So he's gonna look at me immediately and shoot me. So on 6s.
You're good.
Okay. I'm not gonna die yet.
Let's just do it. Okay. He's all over here.
He's moving 5 inches towards the closest model, which is Leland.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yep.
Okay.
And not ready to shoot.
Nope, not yet.
The one on Josh.
Well, he wouldn't get to shoot, right? Because it's only one action.
Yeah, you only get the one action.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And you need to be within 6 to shoot anyway.
Yeah. Let's do this guy and just see which way he turns.
Okay. So he's gonna move 4 inches.
Okay. So he got 1.
Uh-huh. And he's gonna roll
6. Oh, there he goes. He's facing that way. So he's going this way.
So he's got 3 more to go. Should we roll the 4, right? Alright, excellent. And he's gonna be still stunned for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And this fella right here is gonna move 3.
Well, no, he's got somebody in his front when he goes straight to shooting.
Yeah, I guess he would actually.
Yep.
So he's gonna shoot Steve.
Mm-hmm.
Much like our test game, Steve dodge. Is gone when we start shooting him.
Dodge, Steve, dodge!
No!
How you dodge?
I killed Steve! Oh, see, that's what happens when Steve leaves the room. So Steve is dead, and then there were 3.
Thanks, Steve.
Alright, so next up, now that Steve unfortunately has bit the bullet. We have this cultist right here, who's active, and he's going to attack Josh. So what do you need there? 6?
6.
Yeah. Oh.
And he's good.
All right, so good. There's not another dead assassin there. And that looks like it ends the chaos turn. So going into the next assassin turn. So at the start of our phase, that one stunned assassin is going to become on alert again. And we have some cleaning up that we need to do. So you're probably in the best position to make some moves at the moment, so why don't you go first?
Yeah, so I'm going to take a shot here. And... yep,
okay. That's good. We need to get rid of some of those on alerts.
Okay.
All right.
And I'm going to then check out this room. So it's going to be 1, 2... Let's see what I'm dealing with here.
That's a 2-roomer again?
Yeah.
So we have 7 and 10.
I'm much happier with the 7.
Yeah, only one guy's in there. So there we go. And he starts off stunned. So that's your movement, I guess.
So that was 2. I still have a few more.
Oh, yeah.
That was 2?
That was 2.
3, 4, 5, 6. No, I can't get out of there. 3, 4, 5, 6. Start working my way down here.
Either way works. I mean, they're both going to be like that. One other cultist is already on alert, so he's going to be going towards me regardless, unless I kill him.
Yeah. So in that case, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 plus a 2 makes it 6, and just in case, face that way.
All right. Do you want to take out the cultist you're fighting?
Yeah, let's take a swing out. So, again, it's plus 1, so I need a 3 here. Please hit.
Yep! Hey, okay! That's good, because we don't need these event cards to come up.
No.
We don't need to deal with a space room, that's just bad.
And I'm thinking I might move out of the room and start moving up aggressively that way, if that works for you guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess I can go right behind him, man. 5, 6.
Yeah. And that'll also block off an entrance in case they start to come.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Now, it does mean that that cultist is going to be attacking you in the cultist phase, but...
He'll be swinging at me, but that takes some pressure off you guys over there, so...
It is what it is. And,
you're welcome.
I'm going to face this cultist right there, and I'm going to shoot him with my executioner pistol. So, needing 4s!
Who taught you how to shoot?
I don't know. I'm going to try this again, shooting him with the executioner pistol. Hey, I didn't kill him again.
Who taught you how to shoot?
I'm an adversary assassin. I don't shoot. I get up and I claw things to death.
What do you need to do? What would you need if you had to claw him to death?
I'd still need the 4s, but I'd have 3 dice to do it. You know, you know what? I'm going to burn one of my primaries tactics for a friend zone, and I'm going to try this again. Hey! Okay! Took him out finally. It only took me 3 actions to do it. That's kind of sad. And that is the end of the assassin turn. So at the start of the chaos turn, the familiar moves up one more. So we have 2 cultists that are on alert at the moment. So we're going to be drawing up to 3 event cards. So we have Cacophony of Whispers. So this is a psychic event. One randomly determined assassin, other than the Calyxus assassin, is stunned until the start of the next chaos phase. So, even me, odd you?
How about we just have a dice off?
Dice off? Okay.
Oh, I got this.
Yes. Yeah, of course you got this. So I'm stunned. That's fantastic. And next up, we're going to get a patrol. So a chaos cultist with an autogun has come on to 0.3. So that's all the way in the back there. Oh, you have one back there? Mm-hmm. Excellent. And the final one is a random sweep. Oh, we have our first Chaos Marine. So, a Chaos Marine that's cocked. Chaos Marine is going to be coming on to 3. 3 is occupied, so the next closest one is 4. Yay! Mm. So, and he's all of a sudden active again. So he's, you got one over there?
He's on alert.
So he's on alert. Things are not looking good for the assassins, I don't think. No, things are not looking good. I'm stunned. And if you can just put a stun thing next to me.
Yeah.
Just to remind us of that. So, do you want to just activate him first?
Yeah, let's just see what happens.
Alright. So he's going to activate, and he's going to go forward 2.
Okay.
Yeah, big money there.
Let's just do this guy here.
That guy over there, he's going to go 6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay. So he continues to be oblivious. The Marine sees me. Somebody else roll for the Marine. I don't want to roll my own demise. So you're rolling 2d6, and you get to add plus 1 to this. So you need 5s.
There you go.
All right.
That's
apparently how you roll successfully.
Mm-hmm.
And this cultist over here, on alert, is just going to turn around and go after Josh. So he's just going to smack you with his fists. And he's going to miss. Because that's what's going to happen. And that is going to end.
Oh, we got this guy over here.
And we have him as well. He's going to move 3 inches. All right.
And facing this way.
All right. And that ends the chaos turn.
Okay, so yeah. My guy will be taking a swing at the cultist in front of him, getting a 3+ to kill him. Got him.
All right.
So the question is, do you guys need help over there, or do you want me to keep doing rooms?
I think I need help over here.
I think you should keep doing rooms.
I'm about to have a chaos space marine get off all of my grill, man.
Yeah, hey, that's right. Remember last time when I won the game?
No,
take my advice.
I don't actually remember. I think I was the one who actually caught the final blow. Yeah, that's why. All I recall you doing was opening up a whole bunch of...
Okay, cold. So low, I'm going to go after rooms. High, I'm going to go help them.
All right.
That's what we come down to.
Low. Oh.
High, go help them. Okay, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Do it. Do it. Just at the last minute, you turn away.
6.
Oh.
That's all good work.
Yep. So this guy's not actually stunned. He's all...
He's on alert at this point.
He's all angry. I could try and help there.
Or...
How many wounds does he... How many stamina does he have?
2.
Oh, I can't one-shot him.
I said you just killed the cultist.
I'm gonna kill the cultist.
Ah, boy.
Yeah, let's kill the cultist. That's how you kill a cultist.
And then you're gonna go move in front of me so the Chaos Marine sees you first, right?
Cool, yeah!
No. Come on, man! I need to be protected, I'm stunned.
It's probably a good tactic, all honesty, just to go ahead and block and protect Leland. If you can move through Leland.
I can.
He can.
Because I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
How good is the Chaos Marine in combat? Is he better than in shooting?
He's a Chaos Space Marine. He's going to wreck things in combat.
So he's exactly the same in combat.
He's exactly the same in combat. The difference is that we're better at shooting a lot of the time.
All right, so I would definitely go ahead and block Leland. Well, you have a chance to heal yourself, right, Leland?
I'm not wounded yet. I'm just stunned.
Oh.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah,
four,
I'm just
five,
stunned
six.
From movement.
Oh, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want to see what's in this room.
If it's another Space Marine, I'm going to be very upset with you. So we have 11. And 12. Okay, so we have the teleporter room.
And you guys are getting all mad at me.
Still getting all mad at you.
And you mean the, like, activating room? The power room? The cortex?
Oh, yeah, sorry. That's the activation room.
Yeah.
All right, so we have the teleporting room, and we have the activation room. So that's good.
Now, do I get shot at since I walk through here? No, I don't, because I'm outside of 6.
You were outside of 6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No, he's going to shoot you.
My question, I left the room for a bit, so I'm not sure this happened while I was gone. I didn't see anything at the time, but has anybody actually gone in here to activate the teleporting room?
No,
this is the activation room.
Yeah, that's where
why I just flipped.
Oh, okay, you're okay.
Yeah, and then this is where we actually use it. So the Marine actually would have shot you.
I think
you.
It's Lanslate blocked, though.
Oh, that's right, because models block line of sight.
Yay!
Thanks for being a human shield.
Great.
So I just want to point out, you found the teleporter, I found the activation room.
I found a Chaos Space Marine.
You are useless, and...
I died.
You died, so... Getting stuff done, we don't need the other two. Let him die, let's go get in there.
Did I get shot when I moved up, or should I have gotten shot? I think I was close enough, wasn't I?
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you were.
Yeah, so we...
Just hide behind him.
So we would have missed that. So, okay, let's quickly shoot Josh here.
Oh. Where were those rolls when you were shooting at Steve?
I don't know. Those were the same rolls I was rolling when I was shooting at cultists. Apparently I should just not shoot things. Alright, well that looks like it's our turn. So, on to cultists. Hmm.
Moving to turn 6.
So
we have our fun events here. So we have a random sweep. So a cultist with an auto gun. I don't have any of the D6 over here anymore. They've all somehow made their way over to you.
There's one right here.
I can't.
Oh look, there's 4.
Alright. So a cultist with auto gun is going to come on at 6.
which is...
This could end bad.
This could end very bad. So that's the first one. We have a ghostly tide. All chaos made. Yes! Yes! The Marine's not gonna wreck me this turn.
He just disappears?
No, he goes stunned for a turn.
Okay.
Now the downside is we're not gonna draw that when we're in the Sanctum. No. When we're gonna need it the most. And the final one, Data Daemons. With the exception of the Klux's assassin, assassins cannot perform shoot actions in the next assassin.
No shooting.
This game hates me. Well, I'll go back to make the room.
It makes my shooting better. I get to reroll.
You know what? I should be shooting anyway. It's so true. This is probably for the best for me.
Let's just not let the guy who's got the big sniper shoot.
No, that seems like a terrible idea. So, for the cultist movements, we're going to do the active one first. So, moving up 5 to the nearest, which is going to be me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then this guy over here, who's still on patrol. 3, 1. You're going to go this way. 2, 3. And then this cultist over here is going to move 4. So, there's 1. And look at that. He sees me. So he's going to go on to alert, and then this last cultist is going to move 2.
2, 3, 4.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's a thing. I got a little bit ahead of myself. If you can just move that guy 2. 1, 2, there we go. And the Chaos Marine is stunned, so I'm safe for a turn from him. And no combat. Okay, so you're going to go activate the teleporter?
I'm just going to go in, chill out right here, and just in case... like that, because now I can see pretty much the entire room, and it stops him from moving up here and seeing me.
Yeah, no, okay.
Ninja skills.
What are you gonna do, Josh?
I think I'm probably going to abandon you.
That is the right decision.
Yeah, I'm going for the teleporter.
So we'll go 1, 2, 3. That's wrong way.
Well, let's still do the trick.
Yeah. 4, 5.
He would have got line of sight on you.
No, he wouldn't have.
Yeah, he. Oh no, you're right. He would have.
Yeah. So I'm gonna go there and shift. Did he get line of sight?
Yeah, he would have had line of sight. Mm-hmm. You have to go the other
block.
Way.
No, it's the block in front.
He's
right
here.
No, but if you actually look in the rulebook itself, the example they give actually shows it with a wall.
No, because the walls are front.
You're right.
All right. Yeah. Go ahead and shoot at me.
Rules you got wrong. Sorry.
No, you're not getting shot.
Oh, yeah.
You're not getting shot anymore.
You gonna attack him?
So if I go back here, I won't have line of sight on him anymore then?
No, but then you can get closer to the...
the teleporter.
Yeah, I kind of want to just kill him though. Well, let's see if I kill him and help out just a little bit. Got him!
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, that is one less event thing.
That is true. And that's kind of important right now. Because I mean, any active guys on here are going to affect us when we go into the Sanctum as well. So I'm no longer stunned. And I'm going to boogie out of here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Gonna use a special ability to do a second move action. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Get the teleporter. Get the teleporter.
I don't know if I want to get in the teleporter yet.
If you get the teleporter, I turn it on, you teleport.
Yeah, but if I get in the teleporter, no. I also am alone with 3 Chaos Space Marines.
Yeah, I'd say he stays there in case he's going to help us, because he can't come back after he teleports.
Yeah.
So if he holds down the fort there until we
hold
get there.
Hold the gates, man.
Yeah, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stop right there, facing that way, and that's how I'm going to end my... that's going to how I end my turn. Alright, so I'm just going to end my movement right there, simply because I don't want to be alone in the Sanctum when all a whole bunch of Chaos Marines show up. So my second movement, I'm going to take it... gonna end me there. That's gonna end the assassin phase at this point.
We're looking at it going.
And the familiar moves over to space number 7.
So we only have one guy who's on alert right now because the Chaos Marine is stunned. So we're gonna have random sweep. A Chaos Cultist with an auto gun is gonna show up at number 1. So right back here. And then we're gonna have patrol. A Chaos Cultist at number 1, which is occupied, so the next closest looks to be 5. So Chaos Cultist is going to show up right there, and that's the events for us. So we just looked at the order of events, and the Chaos Marine is actually active again, so there's going to be one more event card being pulled for a Demonic Aura. So until the start of the next Chaos phase, roll a dice,
roll it. It should be a roll a die. Each time an assassin other than the Collector's assassin inflicts a hit on a renegade. On a 5 or 6, that hit is negated with no wound counters placed. That's great. So they basically have a 5-up save now. So over here, we'll activate the one cultist right here. 4. Oh. 1, 2, 3. Hello. And he's... Oh, wait. Well, he can't do anything at this point.
That's it.
Yeah. This guy over here. 1. Why are you guys letting me roll dice? I'm terrible at this.
Apparently, ask Steve.
There's another one. Apparently, I can't roll on the higher end of the D6 spectrum.
Unless you're shooting at Steve.
Unless I'm shooting at Steve. Oh, there we go. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
It's narration.
Okay. So, starting off with the Chaos Priest Ring. He's going 1.
Yay! Just gonna point out, I think you're... Oh, wait, no, Josh is still closer, isn't he?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the cultist over here. Low number. Yeah. 1, 2.
Pass me a D6. Alright. So, who wants to go first?
Why don't you go first and try and kill him and just get on the teleporter.
Alright. So you still want me to go when they're alone, I see.
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna just absolutely shred this cultist. For once.
Just wait there, man. Don't go alone. Just wait till he catch up.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna wait. I think me going alone is a terrible idea right now. The only benefit is I'm gonna make that one Chaos Marine disappear.
I want you to do that. He's blocking me.
Oh, that is true. Okay, I'm gonna take one for the team.
Thank you.
I'm gonna use my second movement to end my turn in there.
Alright.
And does he go immediately then? Chaos Priest Marine goes immediately?
No, it's at the end he teleports.
At the end of the phase.
Good.
So
you can go ahead.
I'm thinking if I come out to here and take a shot at him.
Well, you stop. Well, right,
remember,
there.
You're going to put him on alert as well.
I'm going to put him on alert anyway.
Just go walking over.
Ready? So we're going to go, 1, 2. So you. 2, 3, 4, 5. So, I do got to move one more.
You can keep moving.
Yeah.
And is he within 6 of you? He's going to take a shot at you first.
He's going to take a shot as soon as he's right there, though.
Yeah.
And if he keeps moving, he's going to get another shot.
I see.
No, it's only the first time in Assassin.
Is it only the first
time? Yes, it's only the first time.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
It's only so from here, he should become alert and take a shot at me.
Yeah. So somebody else roll these, because I killed Assassin.
It's here, though.
Is it within 6?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Why is it within 6?
5, 6.
No, because it would just be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No, why is it within 6, though?
Because that's the range of the weapons.
No, but he can see him.
Yeah.
So you're not worried about it. Are you worried about him shooting at you or going on alert?
Yeah, we're going this way anyways.
As soon as he sees you, he's on alert.
Yeah.
Which means he's going to shoot you.
Yeah, that's fine. So he's going to take a shot at me anyways.
I got it.
Two shots.
I'm in the game.
He's fine. Okay. So now I'm going to shoot back at him. So I need 4s on this, but I reroll. Good.
See, that's how you shoot.
All right, and you're within that death is within 6 right there.
Doesn't the wall matter though?
I think it's line of sight.
Oh, that's right. It's line of sight. Yeah.
And he's not getting his save because it's me shooting him.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. There's everything except for the.
Oh yeah, other than the Collexus. Yeah, you're absolutely right. So no save. So we just remembered, because of demonic aura, there's a couple saves that the cultist over here has to make. So on 5+,
okay. He's still dead.
He's still dead. Excellent.
And you done 2 actions, right?
Yep.
Done?
That's my 2 actions.
RQ, you're up.
Alright, I'm thinking I'm just gonna go to here.
And or just shoot the guy in the back.
Yeah, you're right. I'll just shoot him in the back, and then that'll activate, that'll get rid of him, and then I can just start working my way in. Because no one else is on alert, so I don't have to worry about them finding us.
So yeah, I'm just going to be following the pattern.
Yeah, so I'm going to shoot that guy in the back. I'm going to stand to get the aiming bow. No, I'm just going to shoot him. I wish I got that
aiming bow. And he's on alert!
I think you get the aiming bonus anyways, because it's +2 for your ability.
That's only if I stand still.
He did stand still.
Has not moved yet this turn.
Oh, okay,
you haven't moved yet.
No, that's true.
All right.
So it's actually beneficial for you to shoot first.
That's true.
Ask questions later.
There we go. Yeah. Oh, he gets a save.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He gets a
5 plus. Yeah, I got this. Oh, it's a 1.
All right.
He's dead.
Good.
Yeah, I think from now on, we just make Steve roll for the cultists.
Yep.
And then you're going to move?
I'm just checking, double checking to make sure. Has not yet moved this turn. Shoot with that. Yeah, so as long as I shoot first. Okay, that's cool. I thought I had to forfeit my movement. So
no, that's pretty good.
I'm going to go right here and just hang out.
So at the end of the phase, the assassin here teleports away into the Temple of Shades, which I've been calling the Sanctum the entire game. And immediately, all the Chaos Marines disappear. And now we get to place 3 Chaos Marines in the Temple of Shades, which I get to now deal with. So the first one is going to be on a 6, which is right over here. The next one. So the first Chaos Marine shows up right there on the 6. The second Chaos Marine shows up on a 2, right back there. And the third one on a 3, which is right there. So there we go. So the familiar is just going to move up to number 8 there. So we have, what, 8 more turns? Yeah, 8 more turns until we lose. All right, so let's draw an event card. Now, thankfully, we've lost a lot of our alerts. So we're gonna get the Net Titans. So a Chaos Cultist with an auto gun on entry point 2 and a Chaos Space Marine on entry point 4. All right, so they have to go into the Temple of Shades. Now, I wanna say we place the Chaos Cultist first, and that's gonna mean no more Marines. Well, no more Marines can come on, actually. Yeah. Way. So I guess it is just a Cultist. It's gonna come up on the next closest one right there. So, another cultist has appeared.
You're getting a little surrounded there, bud.
Just a bit. Alright, so we got some patrolling cultists here. So this fella right over here is going to patrol 3. So 1, 2, 3, and go over that way. And this one over here, 1. Big movement right there. And that is the cultist turn. All right, so for the Temple of Shades themselves, why don't you roll this time? I've been rolling terrible at Q.
All right, so right here, looking at 4.
So I'm just gonna march forward.
And then for this one, 1. That's not too bad.
The cultist.
The cultist is also going 1.
And this last Marine over here, 2. Big money. So 1, 2.
So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I'm gonna sprint. 1,
which is just enough.
Woo!
Woo!
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh.
6 on a sprint can make it.
I might be able to make this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will put me over here, and I get a 6. I got to come save you guys. Nope.
Nope.
Attaboy, Quirk.
Coming out.
That's okay. We got this. We're good. All right. So I'm going to put Mr. Happy Eversir Assassin Guy and... Oh, should I go after the cultist or one of the Marines? I don't know. What do you guys think?
You're safer going after the Marine in the bottom left corner.
Like this guy?
Because if you go after the other ones, you're going to activate the cultist or Marine close to him.
That's kind of what I'm thinking as well.
You could play the Leland game and just stand there.
That's a terrible game. I hate that game.
But then the Marine on the far right side of the screen, if he rolls, you know, 4, he's going
to
see you.
No, he just needs to roll a... Oh, yeah, because I guess his patrol could turn him around as well.
Patrol could turn around, yeah.
So it's a 50-50 chance he'll actually... Or no, it's a something chance that he'll actually get to that square.
You're
but
right,
it's a team game. If you can start clearing some out, maybe some of the other guys can get in there and...
What's this team game you speak of?
Hey, come on. My team let me down.
Are you really taking advice from Steve right now?
Yeah, really. The one guy who's died this entire game.
Yeah, what am I doing? Why am I taking advice from Steve?
Just really quick.
No offense, Steve.
Taking a hole. Leland, have you taken a wound yet?
No, I haven't, actually.
Wounds?
No.
No, I haven't taken any wounds. Steve, how many wounds did you... Oh, that's right.
Yeah, you've taken 2 wounds.
So much hugging.
So much hugging. All right, so we're actually just going to go towards the cultist. Sorry, Steve. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, he would see you there, would he not?
Nope, he does not see beside him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he doesn't see. So, I can just, you know, pat him on the back and say, hello, how you doing?
Or you can try and kill him.
You can...
Maybe not. That's,
and then activate the sorcerer.
And then the sorcerer can go.
Well, here's the thing. If I kill the Marine...
Then the Sorcerer gets mad and kills us all.
Maybe.
Then the Sorcerer gets mad and kills us all.
Kill him. Kill him.
I
told you to go after the other one.
I want
to
kill the Marine.
We've seen you roll. You can't kill
anything. You've seen me roll.
Except for Steve.
I'm terrible. I just need to roll 2 5 pluses and he's dead.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah, you know what? I got this.
Over here?
I got this.
Oh!
Oh! The Marine goes down! That's right. I don't shoot things. I just claw things to death.
Who's being activated now?
Oh, yeah.
Nobody.
Yeah, nobody line of sight.
Nobody had line of sight of it, and nobody heard it. Except for our giant yelling in amazement and shock and surprise at the fact that Leland managed to pull that off.
So, he's just gonna roll up to, what is that, 9?
That's 9.
Yeah, we gotta get this done quickly.
And Josh would have teleported.
Yeah. So he's just gonna appear over there and give me some help. Alright, event card! We're gonna get an elite patrol!
Hey, remember that Chaos Marine you just killed?
He's back! Oh, that's fantastic.
And it's on 3.
And it's on 3.
And he can see you.
He can see me.
So that means he gets one of these, right?
Yep.
I'm enjoying this way too much, way more than I should be.
You just love the fact that I'm about to get shot up, aren't you?
I'm enjoying the fact that we had this whole, you shouldn't do it, you did it, it worked, I was in shock, and now it backfired.
Yep, now it's backfiring on me. So does somebody want to do the honors and roll the 2d6 to see if I just get
memorized? I mean,
you're not liking this way too much. So needing fives. Wait, fives? Yeah, fives. Oh, look, there's a hit. So I need to do my, where are you centered?
Right on your character.
Right on my character. So I do have a 5-up save against this. Nope, I'm going to take a wound.
So, just a quick reminder. He shot, and that means that it's 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6. So you just activated that guy.
But that's sort of reaction thing. That's the thing.
And then we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and oh, the cultist is now.
But it specifically says reaction shots. Like
let's look this up.
Yeah, like a reaction attack, but it wasn't a reaction. Alright, so we just looked it up, and what it is, it's part of the raise the alarm rule, which is ironically part of the turn summary and not part of the alerting renegades. So basically, because the Chaos Marine has made his attack at this point, it's alerted every other renegade within 6 squares. So I'm gonna have a whole lot of hurt coming on. Should we get the cultist out of the way?
Yeah.
All right, let's get this cultist out of the way. So 3.
Just another theory in there with you.
Oh, hey.
Hi there. I just met you, but I love you.
Let's check out this Marine on the far right side of the screen.
Okay, good. One of the Marines that won't do anything to me right now.
6, which way is he gonna look?
4.
He's looking the right way.
Alright. And this other Marine right there, where is he, how many spaces is he going?
3.
3. 1, 2.
Looking the right way.
Yeah, of course he's looking the right way.
And one more to activate, this, the Sorcerer.
This is why I didn't want to go in here alone.
You're not alone.
Not anymore, Josh is
here. You're alone-ish.
No, Josh is just gonna go, nope, this is where I parked my car. He's gonna go somewhere else.
Oh,
he's only moving 1.
Closest, I guess, would be this way. No, this way would be closer.
I guess either way it really worked for me, but yeah, that makes sense.
So, didn't last game we kill him before he got to move?
Yes.
I blame you.
No, you're the one who told me to go in here. So, we have some couple cultists up here still on patrol. 1, 2, and him, 6. So, pretty soon we're not even gonna have to worry about that particular board anymore. I'm up first.
Okay. Alright. So, now I could get in the teleporter and help you guys, or I could try and clear this board.
Don't be that guy.
Isn't there an achievement in the back of the book?
Don't be that guy. This isn't Xbox, man. This is not Xbox Live. You're not going to get the little ding achievement thing popping up for you.
Steve, if I do it, will you make the ding noise?
Thank you, Steve.
And his turn's over.
Wait,
wait, why'd you cut out my musical bit?
Activate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Drop the mic. You're gonna drop the mic, right?
Mic drop. So I get shot at first.
Oh yeah, you're right. So on five.
Sixes.
Sixes. That's right, because you're a scoop ability. Wait.
So I took one.
Working together, Leland.
Working together.
So I took one.
Helping or hurting.
Okay, and then I'm gonna use my big power. So everybody within six squares of me is stunned until the next assassin phase.
So what is it called? Your Omicron?
Omicron Persei.
Item Lure.
So soul.
So horror. Everybody is stunned.
Everybody renegade. Within. The renegade.
Yeah, all renegades are stunned
within six of me.
Does the wall block it?
Doesn't say so. There's certain abilities that specifically, like my one says, it's going to be within line of sight. This just says everybody within six.
Yeah.
Okay, so it gets a sorcerer as well.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to take shots at the Chaos Marine just for fun. Needing, what's it, fives?
Fives.
Wait, why are you doing third action?
That's not an action.
It's tactic. Can you see the Chaos Space Marine?
Yeah.
With the one right there?
Oh, okay, sorry. I
can't see anybody else.
No, I didn't see what I'm shooting. So
nope.
Okay. So now we'll do my activation, and I'm just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm gonna go to town on this guy. If I get one more d6. So, 3d6 attacks. Hey!
Woohoo!
There's two hits. Oh, do I bio meltdown? Just for fun? Just for fun, do I bio meltdown?
It's a 4 plus.
All assassins and renegades within 6 squares of the Evisor suffer a hit on a dice roll of 4 plus. I just die.
I'd say this is your terrible tactic.
You could kill everybody except the sorcerer.
Yeah.
And then leave the sniper.
I'd say use your
just regular do it.
That sounds like a great idea. I'll do the frenzy on and.
No, do it. Blow up.
No, don't blow up.
I dare you.
We've already said we're not listening to Dave or Steve. So.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We're not listening to
Dave. What did I do?
You died.
You died!
Roll 6.
I love how it's just all in unison there. No! No!
Wow.
Remember when I said you should blow up?
You were blowing up wouldn't have done it.
That didn't work.
Remember when I said you should blow up?
No, your idea is still bad.
That is the old turn.
Okay, he's gonna teleport.
Wee!
Woo!
Woo! Alright, going on the cultist. Moving on to marker number 10.
So, here's the event card. They go no further. All renegades add an additional plus one. Oh, good grief. Plus one to shooting attacks.
Oh, we're gonna die.
Well, they're all stunned still. So I think
until we start.
Until the assassin phase.
Until the assassin phase.
You have to kill them.
Oh, jeez. So as soon as we start moving, they're just gonna start shooting us.
Well, going on to the assassin phase. Because they're all stunned, I thought, right?
No, the Chaos Phase. Well, there's one guy still there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because we're not going to care about over here.
What's he do? He moves an inch.
A
square.
Yeah, one square.
One square.
And he's still facing down that aisle right there. So then we move into the assassin phase. So,
stab him a bunch.
This happens.
Everybody goes active.
I'm not moving anymore. That's for sure. I'm just going to sit there and beaver fight him.
Who has the wound?
Oh,
yeah. Leland's got one and I've got one.
Maybe you guys should need to heal yourselves.
or maybe I should remove the Chaos Lord's colon.
Alright, man, go for it.
Swing. So, my first attack.
Blow up.
Yes, that's he's right. Dead!
Why is he dead?
Because I rolled a six.
That's three wounds.
So, six is kills?
Six is kill. Yeah, I need to roll sixes to get him.
That's it, game over?
That's
so what is the assassin victory?
It's Evisor victory, okay?
Blow up.
My next action, I blow up. Okay, so that's the Marine dead. That's the cultist dead. Aw, the assassin lives. Woo-hoo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Aw, nuts. Then I don't have range on. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I got range on the other Marine, just for fun. Yes! All the bad guys die, except for that one. Alright, so there we go.
Oh, me.
What do you mean? You died in like the first three turns.
I didn't blow up.
I should have blown up.
It would have been amazing. Poof! You still got the sniper left. You could totally take him out.
No, there was the emissary.
They only survived because somebody threw a concussion grenade and nobody saved me.
That's absolutely true. Like, if Josh had not thrown the concussion grenade or whatever that is, the psychic grenade?
It wasn't the grenade, it was the soul hunter.
The soul hunter thing. Well, whatever it was. So there we go. We ended with an assassin victory, which is quite good because, frankly, if we did not take out the chaos sorcerer in that turn, everything was just going to turn around and wreck us. And then,
you guys.
You would have had to come in there eventually yourself.
I could stand in a corner and just shoot stuff.
Guys, is this game replayable?
You know, I think the game is replayable. Yeah. I think there's enough randomized factors to it that we can definitely get another game. So as it is, though, we hope you all enjoy this. We actually had a lot of fun playing it. It definitely ramps up near the end of the game, though. I think we were all getting more involved. Mm-hmm. So we hope you enjoyed it. And, you know, this is for you Vault members out there. We love you guys. So hopefully you enjoyed watching it as much as we enjoyed playing it. Happy Wargaming.